Warning. The show you're about to see contains material unsuitable for children and questionable among most adults. Viewer discretion is advised.
Oh, that's right. That's right, that's right. Oh my goodness, we're having a hilarious time tonight. Let me tell you something. You know, we're going to have a lot of fortunes going tonight, a lot of good fortune. You know, me, I have no luck at all. Took a woman on a date. You try to be silly on a date. She asked me what I do for a living. I said, if I told you, I'd have to kill you. She said, please tell me, folks, okay? Oh, man, you guys know what I'm talking about. You know, astrology, it's tough out there, astrology. It's embarrassing for me. I'm 30 years old, and I'm still a Virgo, folks, okay? You guys know what I'm talking about. There we go. You know, a lot of, you know, they do coffee readings. My psychic did coffee readings, but she changed to tea readings because it's a lot easier on her stomach. Thank you. There we go. Thank you. There we go. Cool crowd. Cool crowd. Oh, my goodness. We're going to have a lot of, you know, we got a wonderful music act. Alien Trilogy is here tonight. You folks excited for that? Let me tell you, I saw those first two Alien movies. The third one, Fincher, I hardly know her, folks, okay? You know what I mean? I give that one the thumbs down. Am I right? You guys know? Oh, my goodness. But please, folks, give it up for yourselves, and we're going to have a wonderful show tonight. You guys ready?
Yeah!
Put your hands together for the mystical one herself, Ambrosia Forke!
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage your host, Ambrosia Forke.
Let me say, let the open mouth of love. Let me reach, let me be, shoot the shots of Tripoli. Let me say, let me crush upon your shore. Let me reach, let me be, show me on the yellow sea.
Thank you so much for joining me here tonight. This is the Ambrosia Forke Hour, a psychic television program that has run for, well, 5 years now. We used to be on the radio, now we're on public access television. And as usual, I'd like to welcome you all with a little humor to start the program. So I'm going to kick it off with a joke. Let me just get my monologue here. Are you guys ready for this joke? Great. So did anybody notice the shift in planetary energies this week? Did anybody notice this? You guys hear about this? So Mars is now in Scorpio. And when asked to comment on this sudden shift, spiritual professors confessed that they spaced on it. I hear you laughing back there, Melissa. Come on out here.
I'm supposed to put this on the desk.
This is Melissa Malt.
Hi, how are you guys? Hi, Melissa, what are you doing?
Hi.
Hi. Thank you for coming.
Thank you so much.
We got a hot crowd tonight. Their aura is red.
Red, my God, lower energies.
Low energy, but a hot crowd.
So how are you been?
It's been a while since I've seen you.
Oh, absolutely. It's been some time, you know. You know, Ambrosia, that I made a trip to St. Augustine. And have you been to Florida?
Yes.
I know, but I don't know everything. So why don't you enlighten us?
Well, I went to St. Augustine, and I've been, you know, we've been on for 5 years, but I've been doing my own kind of side business on the side, you know. Women. So I've been down in Florida, and I went down to St. Augustine, and I went down there for about a week. I collected some seashells, you know. I collected those seashells of all varieties, some sand dollars even, you know this. And I arranged them in a specific pattern. I brought them home with me, laid them out in a very specific pattern, and then I have a young woman come over to my house, and she digitally scans those seashells. And she digitally scans those seashells up onto a hard drive or something like that. And we design custom mouse pads.
Wow.
Yeah.
And I thought that digitizing something like that and scanning it would take its energy away, but do you find that...
I think it just boosts it. Yeah, and so, you know, but I've been kind of out of it. You know, you had such fantastic monologue jokes in the beginning, and I wanted to write some jokes for you guys. And I honestly spaced because you know my partner. My partner just moved up to Colorado.
Oh, yeah, Doreen.
Yeah. And they've been looking for apartments. We're going to move up there very soon. I'm staying here, you know, finishing up. I'm an angel card reader. I'm finishing up the rest of the readings for the month while I'm here, you know. Tying up loose ends, that kind of thing. There's a full moon on Sunday.
Yeah, you can't leave angel card readings unattended. You can't just skip out mid-month.
They have to be finished. If regular people get their hands on this kind of thing...
Well, you know what the internet they will.
I shudder to think. Anyway, my partner's been up looking for apartments. And they're texting me saying, do you want a carport? And I said, what's a carport? And she said, it's not a garage. And so I'm saying... and so while that's been going on, you know, she left last night. And she left last night, and I was going to go home, write some monologue jokes, and I come home, and you know we have an aquarium, a smaller one.
But it's beautiful.
But it's beautiful.
It's beautiful.
We have a small aquarium, and I come home, I turn the lights on, and the lights of the aquarium's already on. They're blue lights. And there were two angelfish.
Oh, my God, Doreen.
Two angelfish. Now I have two angelfish. I take care of them now.
That's great. I'm so happy
for
you.
Yeah, so it's hard to write jokes, you know, when they're loud, when they're hungry. You
oh, yeah,
know?
They're so noisy. That's the one thing I don't like about fish is just all the chatter.
Yes. But I did want to do an introductory angel card reading for the night.
We have time for a card, I think.
Time for a card?
Let's get that deck out. What do you say?
Okay. Before I do, I just want to say, I found this. I just found this.
It found you.
Okay. So, are any of you unfamiliar with angel cards? I'll just give a quick rundown. These are angel cards made by my good friend Doreen Virtue, personal friend. So if anybody says anything, know she's a personal friend. Archangel Oracle cards are very powerful. Archangels are very powerful, wise, and loving guides who can motivate and heal you in miraculous ways. This deck of five Oracle cards by Doreen Virtue will familiarize you with the 15 archangels, give you messages from them, and guide you to answer any question you need. So we'll just pull a card from the show.
Great.
How are you feeling, Ambrosia?
You know, I came in here with an aura that was sort of like a burnt sienna with holes in it, like a piece of celluloid that got heated up. And now I think I'm in a cream state.
A cream state,
yeah.
Thank God.
So can we, is that the card?
That's the card. Well,
right.
I was gonna pull a second, but I got prioritize.
Who do we got?
Archangel Metatron, focus on your highest priorities. I will help you get organized and motivated.
Well, moving right along in line with Metarch, the angel, we are going to take
Metatron.
Sorry, I have a couple channels open in my brain right now. There's a lot of spirit voices, a couple different languages. So if I seem out of it, it's what? No. Yeah, that's why. I'm sorry. So now, if you can see the number on the screen, it is 212-757-1393. I want you to call in with your questions about the future, your questions about the present. Don't ask me anything about the past, because why would you? And I can help you talk to a dead relative about love life, anything that you want. And of course, Melissa will help me. But first, we are going to have a little fun with our audience, as we do on the Ambrosia Forke Hour, with a segment I like to call Remember This? So we're going to give you advice based on things that you may not understand now because they haven't happened to you yet. But they will in the future.
We're mediums.
Yes. Hello.
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 Hi.
Hi. Hi.
Okay, great. So, don't give all your money to a rental car industry. You're going to want to space it out over a few decades. And I know that you're tight with your money currently.
That's true, yeah.
So go in that mindset and let that guide you for the next 30 years, and you'll reap great rewards. I think this
remember this? you remember those green egg grills?
No.
Of course she doesn't. They haven't happened to her yet.
You will. Don't put tofu on them, okay?
Okay.
Put the chicken on at a diagonal angle.
Okay.
You look very familiar. Doesn't she look very familiar?
Yeah, she was been
she
here before.
She looks incredibly familiar.
Hi.
Hi.
I come all the time. It's...
Oh, yes, you do. Yes. Thank you so much for coming.
Hi, thank you.
We love you here.
Oh, thank you. I love you.
So What's good to see you again.
What's your name?
My given name is Mary, but my chosen name is Sparkles.
Fantastic, Sparkles.
Thank you.
It's all about what you want the spirits to call you.
Uh-huh.
Because they'll be the only ones calling you in the end. You don't want to know what they call me.
Yeah.
I think I... No, you don't. I think we've got one more. Oh, yes. Hi. I don't recognize you, but I know your future.
Wow.
Yes. Okay. So you're not going to want to take any job pertaining to childcare. Bad things will happen. Instead, go into some sort of manual labor, perhaps welding, anything that has very hot objects and very heavy objects.
I'm
amazed, yes, I know. but if you have any other details that you want to contribute that I can get a more accurate reading of even further in your future.
I don't think anything you said, like, pertains to me.
So we're going to keep it moving if we have any calls on the line.
Any calls on the line?
Do you have any calls on the line?
Any calls on the line?
We've got John from New York.
John, you remember
Hello?
This?
Hi. Hi.
Hi. I was wondering about the future.
So were we.
Aren't we all?
What do you need?
Yes, I was wondering about it.
Yes.
Yeah? What do you want to know?
How much of the future are we going to have?
Well, you, not much. No, where
Am
are
I
you?
Am I going to die?
Yeah.
Oh, yes, certainly. Are you in upstate New York or are you in Manhattan?
I'm in Rochester, New York.
Okay, you have 12 years left.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry?
Why am I going to die?
Why are you going to die?
Honey.
You're in Rochester, right?
Yes.
Okay, next caller. We have on line two, Sally from hell.
Sally!
Hi.
Hi.
Hi, Sally. What
Hi.
Do you need?
I'm not calling from hell. I don't know why they said that.
Oh. That's a joke.
That's a joke, I guess.
It's like a joke. I was just wondering, I just found out that my rising sign is in Gemini, and it's troubling me.
That's troubling.
It's in retrograde. I don't really know what this means for me, and I was wondering if you guys could shed some light on that.
Do you know your moon, Sally?
Yeah, it's Libra.
Oh. Libra moon.
Honestly,
okay.
Avoid mirrors.
A lot of twos going on. A lot of twos going on, Sally. You need a three.
I feel twos.
And you're what's your sun?
Leo.
That's a cute name.
For a boy? For a girl?
My son is a girl. But yes, their name is Leo.
Good. Good for them. So I think that if you have Gemini and Libra qualities, you should avoid any kind of reflective surface because it might be a chance for your dark spirit to come into the real world and take your body and live as you and create mischief in your life, and nobody wants that.
Do you think that could have already been happening?
There's always a chance, Sally.
You'll never know until you wake up one day and realize your whole life has been puppeted by someone you weren't even.
Oh, my God. I hope that happens. I mean, because then I can wake up.
Yes.
I'm ready to wake up.
Thank you so much for calling, Sally. I think we have a Skype call.
Oh, fantastic.
For our... Is there someone
me.
On the Skype? I know. I don't usually work with this medium, but since I'm a medium, I thought I'd try it. This is why I don't like digital things. It's because they never work. I much prefer the analog and the magical.
Who here likes ghosts?
But who's on Skype? Oh.
Oh my
hello.
God. Hello.
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 Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Welcome to the show.
Hey, what's up?
Who
My
are
name
you?
Is Todd, I'm 21, I'm from California, and I've never eaten a vegetable.
That's disturbing.
Hi, Todd.
I used to listen to your show in my car.
Can we take this call?
But then my car got repossessed. Right now in a spot where I need some help to free myself from a mental problem.
Okay.
A mental and physical problem.
I'm here, Todd. Tell me. Tell me what it is.
I'm here.
It's okay, Todd.
I'm addicted to meth and Xanax.
Okay. Sorry, I could tell.
Yeah. Every 2 days, I wake up from the Xanax, and then I just stay up for 3 to 4 days doing meth. In order to make the money I need, I steal sometimes from people, sometimes pretend to be a Forever 21 clothing store employee, take people's bags who shop at Forever 21, mm-hmm. and then return it for cash back at another Forever 21.
Yes, the short grift, I'm familiar with it.
I just want to know if I can use psychic abilities to get over this.
Yeah, I think there's many things you can do. One of the things you can try is visualization. See yourself out of the addiction, and then you'll be better. You just have to follow through with what's in your mind.
Yeah, I can try visualization.
Yeah. So.
And then I want to know if you could help me with a prediction.
Of course, Todd.
Of course.
Yeah.
What do you want me to predict?
I want to know if you can predict these nuts.
Oh, cut the call. Cut the call. No Skype. Then. Get it away. See, this is why.
Yeah, man. All right.
I'm so sorry.
This is why I don't like opening up the channels of the internet.
Shut it down.
Shut it down and plug it up, I say. Yeah. Honestly, net neutrality, we don't need it. This is the spirit channels, you can't control those. All right, so we have a call. Steven from Daytona Beach. What's up? Steven? You're on with Ambrosia Forke and Melissa Malt.
Oh, hello. Nice to talk to you guys.
Hi, Steven.
Hi.
What do you need?
I need you to bless my friend's Alien Trilogy first.
You need me to,
To bless Alien Trilogy?
Oh, of course.
Oh.
Okay, thank you.
We did
I'm
a
just worried for their souls.
Oh, no, we did a protection spell before they even got here.
You didn't know what we did before we went live.
Yeah, we had to kill a cat. Anything else you want?
I actually had a test Wednesday or Tuesday where I had to look inside of a cat and like pinpoint which parts of the cat there were. So
you must have seen the barbed penis of the it was a male cat. So did you save that and dry it out?
We didn't go too much in the reproductive but
okay, that's a great fertility spell. I'm sorry, Steven.
Missed out.
Lost opportunity.
And also can you help me, like can you give a prayer or a blessing for me to catch more fish, please?
Yeah. Are we talking about fish in the sea, or are we talking about ladies on the Daytona Beach where you are?
No. I don't want the ladies on Daytona Beach, believe me. I just want more fish to catch my rod and reel.
Of course, of course.
Sorry?
Anything for a Californian fan. I myself am Los Angeles renowned as a vibrational energy expert. So my prayer, of course, Stephen, my prayer to you, you're welcome. Okay, on line three we have James in England. James.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello. Nice to meet you, Ambrosia. Long time viewer, first time caller.
Oh, thank you, James.
Yeah. So I was wondering if you could help translate a dream I just had last night.
Sure.
It was kind of like Kafka-esque. I felt like I was in a trial. Like there were several trials. And my old college professor was there. And
of what subject?
In the end, I died.
Oh,
that sucks.
What subject did your professor teach?
English.
And where are you?
I'm in England.
You gotta move. You gotta get out of there. That's what that's telling you.
Well, where should I move?
I don't know. Just Brexit yourself. Anywhere that's never been colonized by the UK, just somewhere that they have not touched is where you need to be.
Oh, very well. And then there's one more thing I want to know if you could see.
Sure.
These nuts.
James.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
Hang up on James. James.
No, give it.
All right, we're going to take our final call. We have Royce from San Francisco. Thank you for showing me so much love, California.
No problem. I was wondering if you could tell me, I have a twin brother named Chris. Could you tell us how we're going to die?
I'm sorry, you're asking me.
How were you born?
Yeah.
Who came out first?
I can't predict anything without that information.
We were fighting, but I managed to get out just a second before him.
Second before him.
You take this one.
So you weren't that much stronger than him, were you?
We're about equally matched at the moment. Whenever we fight, it just goes on a really long time until we both get tired and stop.
Twins.
Yeah, it's gonna hurt really bad when it happens.
Yeah. Whichever one of you dies first, the other one will feel it. So it'll, in a way, you'll both die. Thank you so much for watching and calling.
Thank you.
So I hope that you were all enlightened from that segment.
Yeah.
Okay, you know what? We're going to shift gears a little bit. We're going to take one of you lucky audience members and give you a psychic makeover, because I can feel there's an energy emanating from this audience of a non-believer, and I want to just...
Skeptic?
Yeah, a skeptic. I just want
what?
To... Sparkle, can you take this gentleman to the center?
Yeah.
Please rise.
Give it up for Sparkle, everybody.
Right here, right here.
Thank you, Ambrosia.
This is my favorite part of the show.
Hi, what's your name?
Tanner.
Hi, Tanner. Would you say that you've ever felt psychic energy before or perceived a spirit?
No, I don't really believe in, like, crystals or Enya.
Well, you don't have to believe in them because they exist. But your mind seems to be perfect fertile ground for our psychic makeover. So if you'll follow Sparkle, we can check in with you in a few minutes and see the results of this Inside Out makeover that we perform on this program regularly. Great.
Hi.
So, thank you for that. It's so great to have fans who come back and can assist with segments on this show. We've got another segment for you all, a little treat from the future, actually. I have my trend correspondent, Q, and they recorded a dispatch for us that we're going to talk to them now about from the future, from the year 2018. So let's check in with Q.
Q?
Q, are you there?
Q?
Hey, Ambrosia.
Hey, how's it going?
The style correspondent for 2018.
All right, what's up with the trend?
Ambrosia?
Q?
Are you there?
Yes. Q? Q.
Oh, sorry. I think the connection was messed up.
Okay,
hey,
great.
Ambrosia, it's me, Q, your staff correspondent for the year 2018. I'm here in New York City, and I want to tell you about the hottest trends that are sweeping the nation right now. So let's get right into it.
Great.
The first one is a body modification trend that started in New York, but is quickly being seen in places like Chicago and LA, and that is digit minimalization. So I just had this digit minimalization procedure on me in a St. Mark's piercing shop, and it was great. Service was excellent. I highly recommend it.
Great.
So what people are doing, especially millennials, is taking their digits and removing some of them, consolidating them so that we can make file sharing easier and have less fingerprints so that the government can't trace us easily. So let me demonstrate for you just how file sharing is so easy when you have digits minimalized. So yeah, it's like a whole new world. Another thing that's going on, health-wise, a huge trend, charcoal fasting. People are consuming massive quantities of charcoal so that their excrement and their sweat is pitch black, thus absorbing solar energy so they can convert that to currency, because now that all the banks failed, we have to use solar energy, which we can sell in the black market to get things like food and water. So that's a really great way to do it. And like, I knew it was going to be big in 2016 when Gwyneth Paltrow started eating charcoal, but I didn't know it was going to be this big and literally be like one of the only ways that we can survive as Americans. Yeah, it's pretty crazy. Hold on a second, I'm getting a call. Uh-huh. This is cute. No, I can't make it. No, I'm still in hiding. Yeah. I actually, I need you to never call me again at this number, because the government can trace my phone. Thank you so much. So sorry about that. So yeah, moving on to fashion. One of the biggest trends in fashion right now is horrible. It is that the alt-right has taken over our mainstream media outlets and indie and cultural media outlets, such as Vogue Paris, Vogue Italy, Vogue Tokyo, and they're kind of using that as their new platform. So you're part of the fashion rebellion if you look like me. What I have going on is some DKNY, Diesel, a few discarded pieces of scrap metal that I've then ionized to look reflective so that it can bounce flash, so that when people are taking a picture of me, my facial recognition is obscured so that I won't be traced. And this is Nike. But if you look like the mainstream, you're reading the pages of Vogue Paris and you see, oh, look, Balenciaga just came out with their line of fedoras called the Neckbeard Collection. No, thank you. That's not for Q and not for you. Do you have any questions for me?
Yeah, I wanted to know what happened with the presidency.
Why am I in hiding?
Yes.
Isn't it obvious?
Well, can you tell me about the trends in music now or something like that?
Define music?
Well, right now, everybody around the world is listening to Mariah Carey's comeback rock pop anthem hit, Born in the American States. And it's sort of like evocative of the social climate right now, because after the election was what it was with the new regime in state, we had to sort of have this nouveau 60s movement in terms of people's political involvement, where we kind of returned to the 30s in a bad way, like a really bad way, honestly. Like I did mention, I'm in hiding right now. And yeah, I just, hold on, I gotta check what time it is. God damn it. Yeah, so I have to go underground because they're going to be doing checks soon, and I can't be above ground or I'll be thrown into one of the torture cells. Well, see you guys later. Thank you so much for having me on your show, Ambrosia.
Thank you for being here.
I hope you guys can stay trendy in 2017, and honestly, good luck, because you're going to need it. You know what I mean? Well, I guess that you don't.
Ooh. Okay. Thought it was going to be a little more light with maybe some lip gloss recommendations, but you have it. That is what we have to look forward to. Let's just clear the air with a little music. As you know, in our program, we like to welcome different forms of art. And our tonight's musical guest has a new tape out on Kitty Play Records. It's called Rat Damage. And they're going to be playing a basement at Max Fish in Manhattan on March 13th. Please welcome the band Alien Trilogy.
Yeah! What do you wanna? Get the chip out? Why don't you leave it? Leave it in your hand! What do you wanna? Get the chip out! Why don't you leave it? Leave it in your hand! I wanna stay the same.
the three seashells. Oh, you beautiful bastard. I gave you one chance and you screwed it up. Woo! Cut the crap. I love ya. Woo! Cinemania! 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 Downtown! Cinemania! Cinemania! Downtown!
That was great. Thank you, Alien Trilogy. That was out of this world.
Woo!
Okay, I didn't know how that joke was going to go, believe it or not. So I would like to welcome one of my oldest friends to the program. Of course, not older friend than you are to me. But this is a very special person, not a psychic, but a witch. And her name is Broom. Please welcome Broom.
Thank you. Ambrosia, it's so lovely to see you.
And you too. Mm-hmm. Although I saw you about a week ago coming here, mm-hmm. and I just got so excited. So I've been excited mm-hmm. for about a week.
I've been seeing you on the astral a lot. Your chakras look great.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.
Thank you.
So I'll introduce myself.
Of course.
Yeah. My name is Broom. I am a witch, a healer, and a high priestess of a brand new coven / social media-based marketing firm. And so lovely to be here with you.
Yeah, and you too. And you have a bookstore.
I do. I have a bookstore. It is called No Magic for Old Men. Please come check it out. We just buy things off of Amazon and we sell them there.
That's so great.
Oh, and it's magic with a K. And an H and
a C.
A C.
And a Y.
And a Y.
And an I, yeah. And
an M. I think there's also like a T in there. I don't know.
Yeah, it was the one of the medieval letters. It's a combination of a T mm-hmm. and an M.
It makes a sound.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's magic. Mm-hmm. Something I've practiced for a long time. Mm-hmm. That's actually how we knew each other. Yeah. Was from, I believe, like a drink and potion making thing in Brooklyn.
Like a drink mm-hmm. and draw.
Yeah, but with mm-hmm. potions. Mm-hmm. That was great.
That was lovely.
Do you want to, this may be like a little putting upon you, but I was feeling like since the solstice is so soon, we should probably do a prayer to the goddess.
Mm-hmm. I have a prayer that I recently created with my spirit animal, Shrill Crow. I could do for everyone if you want.
I would love that.
Yeah.
Would you guys like to see us a prayer to the goddess? Take it away, Broom. Sweep us off our feet.
Oh, goddess, I need your help. There are no beets at the Whole Foods. There are no collard greens. Collard greens are the new kale. If you didn't know that, then you're not a witch. If you didn't know that, then you're not a witch. You'll get it. I am a witch in Brooklyn. I ride my bike to the Whole Foods in Gowanus. I don't need a broom, cause the cleaning lady brings her home. Why would I need another? That's pretty wasteful. Yeah. I am a witch in Brooklyn. Thou shalt not
no, or Hecate will come and spit in your soy cappuccino for eternity. That was a curse that I found on Tumblr, but it probably won't work, 'cause I couldn't find the heart of a virgin cow. They didn't have it at Whole Foods. I fucking love Whole Foods!
Yeah.
They have all the shit that you need as a witch, like spices and shit, and herbs and shit, and dried chickpeas and shit, which you can't use in any spells, but they're really affordable if you buy them in bulk. Sure, I am a witch in Brooklyn, Brooklyn. I talk to American spirits on my smoke break. I am a witch in Brooklyn, Brooklyn. The goddess got me into my first choice grad school. I am a witch in Brooklyn, Brooklyn. And I know that the goddess exists. She exists, hell yeah. 'Cause I got a
break.
Hello.
Oh my God.
Someone ordered a god.
No.
No.
Sorry, everyone. This is PENOS. He's an ancient.
Hello.
Oh God.
Hello. I am PENOS.
No. Oh my God. I'm
PENOS,
so sorry.
PENOS. All hail PENOS.
Okay. PENOS. PENOS.
Oh, no. PENOS.
I'm sorry, Broom. PENOS.
Yes.
This is. Okay, if you're here, can you at least face camera, PENOS?
Yes.
I know you're centuries old, but get with it.
PENOS! The all-powerful PENOS.
Yeah, so this is Broom.
I love you, PENOS! Yonder!
Hi, Broom.
I think she accidentally summoned you because we were doing a prayer and invocation to the goddess, actually.
Yes, the gods.
The goddess.
Gods,
I think you have a hearing problem in whatever tier you're on in the astral plane.
The highest one.
Yeah.
Why? I'm all powerful.
So you're in the nosebleeds of the astral plane. You can't fucking hear the spirits,
hear
right?
Point
I'm sorry.
PENOS,
I'm sorry.
The immortal. From the astral plane.
You know what, PENOS? Why don't you have a seat on the couch and stick around in YouTube room?
Do you have a throne instead?
PENOS. PENOS.
PENOS.
Yes.
PENOS.
PENOS.
My other buddy.
PENOS.
You know, I just want to say, before I sit.
Please speak. You are a god.
You don't need to give me permission for that. I'm a god. PENOS!
PENOS!
Oh, yeah, my boys. You know, I am all powerful. I am one of the most powerful deities in the universe. However, I can tell, and I am not blind to the fact that I am surrounded by some powerful women here tonight. Fine. However, I'm not blind to anything because of my unlimited gaze. And not that kind of gaze.
I'm sorry, okay.
Not that there's anything wrong with that. I'm PENOS. Oh, PENOS.
PENOS. You can't talk about yourself in the third person.
I must.
No, PENOS,
no. So dated. Can you please sit down, PENOS?
Oh, PENOS, all right. Ah.
Easy, PENOS.
Oh, God, I'm so sorry, Broom. I'm so sorry.
Your name is Broom.
My name
Delightful.
Is...
Delightful.
Your name is PENOS.
PENOS.
Yeah.
The Omnipotent.
Oh, I'm so sorry. We actually have an unconventional guest coming up next, but the network said that we had to diversify the kind of people that we brought on the show. So we have a stand-up comedian.
I love comedy.
Yeah, this actually, you showed me this person on YouTube.
Yes, and such then, a dynamic performer.
Well,
you'll see.
Why don't you come on out, Ducky?
Yes! Yes!
Yes.
Hi, it's so great to meet you.
It's great meeting you as well.
Okay, well, the stage is yours, Ducky.
Actually, I would like to propose something to you, if I may, if that would be good with you.
Well,
before I
do
before
have I, a, I have a covenant with the goddess, so it can't be any kind of proposal, but
the goddess allows you to.
PENOS, please.
PENOS.
Will the PENOS heads in the crowd just be quiet, please? Ducky, go right ahead with your proposal.
Well, I've been having a certain sort of dreams lately, nightmares, I guess, if you should call them that. And, well, they are taking me to a place where I meet a certain soulmate of mine, perhaps somebody who will be with me for an entire lifetime. Is this in fact true? Could you perhaps lead me through the way of the gods, Goddess Pino?
PENOS, it's wrong.
There's wind flame.
I can tell that you have a deep desire for a soul connection with another. This is why you're doing stand-up, right?
Not exactly. You see, I've been doing stand-up for a long, long time, since I found out that I could make people laugh. So it's not about that, but sure, when I do it, I do hook up quite a lot.
Well, if this is your main channel of expression, and this is what people are being drawn to you from, then I think you should stay with this path in order to complete the dream that you're having. But I can tell that you have a joke for us, if you would like to say.
Yes, of course.
Please, the floor is yours.
Hit us, Ducky.
Hello. Woo. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. You may have noticed that my name is a little bit peculiar, and that is because my actual name is particularly long. Very well. And you see, my name, people call me Ducky, because I am just like a little duck. I get wet and I get dirty, and I'm always in it for a good time.
Thank you, Ducky. That was...
Perhaps now you would bathe me in your crystal spirits.
Yes, you've given me a lot of light and joy from that joke, and I would like to express my light and joy all over your body now. So if you could lie down.
Finally.
I'll take this device from you.
I've never made love before.
All right.
I have had a great deal of sexual desire my entire life.
Ducky,
never have I been able to fulfill it until now.
I'm going to need you to keep this right here. And one here and one here.
Shall I lick this?
That's up to you, Ducky. All right. We're taking the seed and we're dragging it down. And we're taking the seed and we're dragging it up. And the spirit can decide. And the spirit can decide, and the spirit does not, okay. And the spirit, we are trying to find the love channel. It appears to be that the love channel is currently blocked. I will address this signal problem later. There's probably too many cell phones
on
in the audience.
No, I don't think that is true. I did feel a great deal of sexual desire right here, so perhaps you should put the...
I think I'm going to need...
You should take them from that area.
Okay. This is not exactly what I expected.
Perhaps an audience member can take
Let's check in on our psychic makeover subjects. Please return.
The psychic makeover.
Okay, I'm just gonna. Great. Oh wow! Thank you, Sparkle.
Fantastic. You're welcome. It's my pleasure.
Oh, so you've listened to the tapes, I see.
Yes, I have.
And how do you feel now regarding your spirituality and sense of self?
I can truly feel my Orinoco flow.
That's great.
My energy is taupe.
Yes, it is.
And you didn't believe in any of this stuff before we made you over, did you?
I was an unbeliever. I was foolish.
And now? And now?
I believe.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Petunia!
Yes, Mother. It's me. Your strange daughter, Petunia Forke.
How did you get here? I don't understand.
I've come back to take what's rightfully mine, the spotlight.
You never understood the powers of your own mind, preferring to rely on your body's strengths rather than develop your psychic abilities. You're no daughter of mine.
Yes, and where has it gotten me? I'm singing all over Hollywood Boulevard. And in clubs and colleges all over New York.
I told you to join the Psychic Academy so you could strengthen your mind powers, but instead, you chose to pursue your dream of becoming a singer. Why didn't you listen to me and work on the power that I gave you from birth?
Where has it gotten you? You're taping a live episode of your psychic call-in radio show that's been around for decades. That's like digging your own grave in terms of the biz show business. That is.
Oh, don't give me that. What are you doing? No, you can't do this. No, no.
That's right, Mother. You just sit down and watch while I take the stage.
I've got to fight her psychic energy. I have to stop her. I have to break these mind cuffs.
It's my turn now, Mommy. 1, 2, 3, 4. When you're alone and life is making you lonely, you can always go downtown. Whenever worries are the noise and the hurries can help, I know. Downtown, just listen to the music and the traffic in the city. Listen to the rhythm and all the neon signs are pretty. How can you lose? The lights are much brighter there. You can forget all your troubles, forget all your cares, and go to California. Oh, California, coming home.
I have to fight her somehow.
Gonna give me folks an E. This is Sunset Peak, California. Don't you remember you told me you love me, baby? Said you'd be coming back this way again.
Enough of that. We're going to hear again from Alien Trilogy before this continues any longer. Woo! Cut to the band.
Don't kill me! I'm not dead!
the basement! The door! Don't kill me!
What do you want? Throw down your cross, face the master, your faith versus his face. Could you do that? Is your faith enough?
Don't show me! You got! In the basement! Hold the line! In the basement! Quick door! Don't kill me! I'm not dead!
PENOS delight, yes! Well, you've joined us on a very special night. That is because... Whoops. Whoops. That is because... Tonight, we are going to have a telekinetic battle live on public access television. All right, here are the rules. They will control an avatar, and then whoever dies, the avatar, of course, they will be the loser. And, that's it.
Winner takes the other's powers.
Yeah, winner takes the other's powers. I'm PENOS.
PENOS!
Love you.
Don't do this. Don't do this.
I'm sorry, Melissa. It had to be done.
Of course it does.
Let's settle this, daughter.
What? And for all.
God, I didn't think that.
Hey, what the frig is going on? Here?
No, nothing. There's nothing to see.
All right.
No. No. This was not in the cards.
Yeah.
Oh boy.
Well, you might want to shuffle that deck, sweetheart, because someone looks a little dead here.
Yes. Oh.
All right. So we're gonna have a little chat right now. What? What happened here?
Well, I'm a psychic. This is my daughter. She came here and
was
challenged
your daughter.
Challenged my authority, and we had a winner takes all in terms of soul, life, and powers battle, and she lost. So
yeah, she's fucking dead. So
is there any way we can make this go away?
Yeah, we're gonna make something go away, and it's you, sweetheart.
So I'm just gonna put my wrist in that handcuff attached to your neck.
This is where regular handcuffs go. That's true. Yeah.
I'm PENOS!
PENOS!
Hey, yeah! How's it going?
No. Hi. You arrest her, no, okay? None of that.
I'm not gonna say
it's
anything
PENOS.
Else until I have.
I'm Fred, by the way.
All right, nice to meet you, Fred.
That's PENOS.
Yeah, has anyone seen my Kid Rock shirt?
Dude.
Oh my God.
No, okay. PENOS. I heard he's gonna run for Senate. It's gonna be great. All right.
Yes, all right.
I told you to prioritize.
I'm sorry.
And I'm just gonna pop myself in here to be safe.
When I tried to foresee, I told you what happened, that the crystal shattered in my hand, and I thought it was just a disturbance in the field, but...
I know, but I thought you were a little rusty.
Melissa.
Pardon me, part of my...
Oh. You're gonna have to work harder than that, you,
right,
you
well,
fucking cop,
well,
you fucking pig, oh. You fucking pig.
Oh, okay.
Take
Come
me away,
on.
I'm going to get my psychic lawyer on this.
I love you,
I absolutely knew this was going to happen. Oh, yes. Oh, yes, I knew. I've known Ambrosia a long time now. I don't know if anybody else knows that, but I've known her a long time. We go way back. The second she asked me, I said, "Where's Petunia?" Because I knew she was going to be involved. And when the two of them get together, you know, they're like ducks in a pond. You know, when bread's coming around, they're going to fight. And I don't know. I don't have much time for violence anymore. You know, I'm getting older, and I have two angelfish now. It's hard to record a podcast or do a radio show or something like that when you have two angelfish making noise in the background because they're hungry. I'm excited to move to Colorado. I don't know what it's going to be like. I don't have any friends up there, but I'm going to have to make them, you know? I'm spacing out here.